Hi, Victory Kids!
Happy Easter, everybody. I hope you guys had a great week and you are still celebrating Easter even if we're at home. Today, Miss Heidi and I are going to start off with a fun Easter game, and I think you guys are going to enjoy it today. Are you ready to play?
I think so. I'm a little bit nervous because this is kind of a scary game, but this is how it's gonna work. Me and Miss Emily have two containers. Inside are three jelly beans each. We have to pick, well, they're the same jelly, they're the same colors. We are gonna pick a jelly bean, and it's either gonna be the flavor of
Tutti Frutti
or Stinky Socks. So someone's got Tutti Frutti and someone's got Stinky Socks. And then we're gonna see who gets the gross jelly beans. Hopefully it's her. Okay, so we're gonna start with these ones. These ones are, what color is this one?
This one is going to be the pink speckled one. So,
okay.
I'm gonna start.
Here's my pink speckled one, hold on. This one?
Yep.
Okay, count us down, ready? Help us count. One, two, three.
I got the good one.
Oh, that is bad. Oh, okay. I thought it was fruity at first. Socks are not fruity. Okay. I hit my ears with the sticky, gross stuff. Okay, next one. Our flavor is either berry blue.
Or toothpaste, not too bad. Not too
bad. Okay, which one is that one, the blue one?
The blue.
All right.
Get my other jelly bean. All right.
One, two, three.
I got toothpaste.
I was like, mine tastes good.
Nope. Guess it's kind of like a mint, but not really.
Are you gonna swallow it?
It's only mint, so.
Yeah. Mine kind of tastes minty though, too. Yay, okay. Last one.
Oh,
we got birthday cake.
Or dirty dishwater. I hate the dishes, first of all.
Hopefully you get that gross one. Okay, last bean. Okay, ready? One, two, three. Yay! Mine's good! Sorry, Miss Emily.
I don't even know what dirty dishwater tastes like, but I don't think it tastes like that. It tasted like dirt.
Oh, it did? Oh, I'm sorry. Well, if you've got this game at home, you can play too. Or you just eat regular jelly beans.
All right, Victory Kids, it's time to get up and move. I hope you guys watched Mr. Jacob's challenge at the end of the video last week. Me and Miss Heidi, of course, we are going to do the challenge as well. So if you want to do it with us, get up from sitting down and we are going to start. Are you ready?
Yep, what are we doing?
We are doing 10 push-ups.
All right. Okay, ready?
Okay.
Okay. Ready? Make sure hands don't slip.
Okay, ready?
Yeah.
One. Two.
Oh, that's hard.
Three. Four. Five.
Six. Six.
Seven. Eight.
One more.
Yay.
Victory Kids, it's time for our song. So stand up. Mom and Dad, you can help us too. It's one of our favorites. Don't hit your neighbor. You need a little bit of elbow room, okay? So here we go. Father Abraham. We're going to do our Bible story. Good job! Good job, Miss Emily.
Oh my gosh!
Miss Emily, that was so much fun. Thanks for dancing and singing together.
Yeah, it was so fun.
Yeah. I like your bunny ears, by the way.
Thank you. I like yours too. But bunny ears and candy and all this Easter fun stuff, it's so much fun and all, but it's not why we as Christians celebrate Easter.
Why do we celebrate Easter?
Well, remember our story last week?
Yeah.
Yes. So we left off where Jesus died at the end, and it was very sad. It was a sad ending. But we have part two this week of our Easter story. Are you ready to continue our Easter story?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. So we're going to do a little bit of a recap. So Jesus was arrested and people made fun of him. After Jesus was beaten, they made him carry this big, heavy cross on his back all the way up the mountain. They put nails in his hands and feet, and he died on the cross. And that's where we left off last week. But why did Jesus die on the cross? Jesus died for our sins, and that's what we talked about last week with our demonstrations. He died on the cross to take our sins away from us. Sins are all the bad things that we have done. Jesus knew, and he didn't want us to be punished, so he took our punishment for us.
Before the sun rises on that Sunday morning, the earth begins to shake, and an angel rolls the heavy stone aside. The soldiers run away in terror. They don't know what's happening. In the morning,
Mary and her friends hurry to the tomb where Jesus was buried. When they get there, the stone has been moved and the tomb is open.
Open? What do you mean the tomb was open? So they could just see Jesus in there? Or was it empty? Like, why was it just open?
Well, I'm gonna do an experiment for you today. I have two eggs here. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna let you hold this one for me, carefully. If I were to take this egg and crack it, what do you think would come out? What would be inside?
Scrambled eggs.
Scrambled eggs. When they went to the tomb, they were expecting to see Jesus, right?
Yeah.
That's where they put him. No one could get in. Let's see. Okay, that's egg. What do you think will happen if I open this egg? What do you expect to see inside?
More scrambled eggs.
More egg stuff, right? It's empty. There is nothing inside. Just like the tomb, it was empty. Jesus was gone. He was risen. Just like the empty egg, Mary and her friends see the linen cloths and an angel. Jesus is not there, but the angel tells them that Jesus has risen. He's gone. He isn't dead, but he's alive.
So Jesus defeated death and he lives and he's alive today. That's a pretty good ending.
It is. It's the best. Better than last week, right?
Mm-hmm. Way better.
Amen. So we're going to pray and we're going to ask God to help us this week, okay? We don't have to be sad anymore because Jesus is alive. He loves you. He died on this cross for your sins and he wants you to be happy and healthy. And we're going to pray right now. So if you guys are ready, let's close our eyes. We're going to talk to Jesus. He loves when we talk to him, okay? So close your eyes. Jesus, we love you today. We thank you that you are alive, that you are risen, that you are our Savior and our King. We come before you today, God, and we honor you today as we celebrate Easter. Lord, I pray that you would watch over all these Victory Kids and their families, that you would bless their day today, God, as we celebrate you. We give you praise, we give you glory. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Can you guys all say, thank you, Jesus?
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
We are so glad that you guys joined us for our Easter lesson this week. We have a new challenge for you this week. In the Easter bags that you guys picked up, there was a coloring sheet, or it may be in your parents' email. Your challenge this week is to color that Easter page as best as you can. Me and Miss Heidi are gonna do the same exact thing. And then have your parents take pictures of your coloring page and submit your entries to us. There will be prizes for the winner. Just kidding. So that's your new challenge. We will see you next week. We hope you have a great rest of your week and happy Easter.
Happy Easter. Bye, Victory Kids.